Hello students, a very good morning to you. Today we will continue at chapter 14 of class 11, that is respiration in plants. And today we will study about respiratory balance sheet, then respiratory quotient and respiratory pathway and amphibolic pathway. So now let's start about respiratory balance sheet. Dear students, so what is respiratory pathway? It means the total amount of ATP is used during respiration. How it is used and why it is not possible to consume or to produce all the ATPs during respiration. That's why there are some demerits or some arguments about the respiratory balance sheet. Means the respiratory balance sheet cannot be true or cannot be valid for the living system. It means we cannot make a respiratory balance sheet for the living system. So what are the reasons that we can't make a respiratory balance sheet and they are not valid for living organisms? Because all the ATPs or all the processes that take place inside the plant is not take place simultaneously. Clear? It means मैं ये बता रही हूँ कि जो रेस्पिरेटरी बैलेंस शीट है इसको हम कैलकुलेट नहीं कर सकते हैं लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म में. क्यों? क्योंकि कुछ रीजन की वजह से ये वैलिड नहीं करता है. ठीक है? कैसे? जैसे कि जो प्लांट्स होते हैं उनमें कई सारे प्रोसेसेस साइमल्टेनियसली होते हैं, एकदम से होते हैं, तो जिसकी वजह से ये क्या होता है, रेस्पिरेटरी बैलेंस शीट निकालना मुश्किल होता है. ठीक है? अगर ये एक के बाद दूसरा होता प्रोसेस, सपोज फोटोसिंथेसिस के दौरान रेस्पिरेशन नहीं हो रहा है या फिर अदर मेटाबॉलिक एक्टिविटी नहीं हो रहा है, तो अलग चीज़ है. बट यहाँ पे हर चीज एट ए टाइम हो रहा है, साइमल्टेनियसली हो रहा है, जिसकी वजह से हम इसको वैलिड नहीं मानेंगे लिविंग सिस्टम के लिए. फिर से जो ATP फॉर्मेशन होती है रेस्पिरेशन के दौरान भी और फोटोसिंथेसिस के दौरान भी, इट मीन्स द ATP that is synthesized during photosynthesis and respiration are utilized by the plant when it is needed. Clear? So the ATP is utilized by the plant when it is needed. That's another reason. Or we can say that rate of enzymatic action that takes place in plants for doing different activities are also takes place in different ways. This is also one reason that we can't make the respiratory balance sheet. Means in some areas or in some reactions ATP needed is high and in some areas ATP needed is low. Clear? So if the person will ask why we can't make the respiratory balance sheet for living organisms, means for plants, this is because of the following reasons which I have explained. Now we will study about respiratory pathway and amphibolic pathway. First, let's understand what is amphibolic pathway. Amphi means dual. Amphibolic pathway, the pathway that takes place in dual process or which takes place in a dual way is called as amphibolic. But here, respiratory pathway is called as amphibolic pathway because here both anabolic activities and catabolic activities are taking place. Or we can say in biological terms, when both anabolic and catabolic processes are occur in plants, this is called as amphibolic pathway. Anabolic means synthesis of new substances and catabolic means breakdown of complex substances. Or we can say anabolic means synthesis of complex substance from some simpler one and catabolic means formation of simple substance from complex, simple to complex, complex to simple. So this is called as amphibolic pathway, or we can say metabolism is the best example to define amphibolic pathway because metabolism is equal to anabolism plus catabolism. That's why in anabolism simpler substances combine to form complex substances and in catabolism complex substances break to form simple substances. So how this occur? As we know, like plants, we also animals take different type of foods and the major foods we eat are carbohydrate, protein and fat. सो हाउ दे गेट ऑक्सीडाइज, आर दे डायरेक्टली गेट ऑक्सीडाइज और थ्रू डिफरेंट सिंपलर फॉर्म्स. सो वी विल सी, एंड यू ऑलरेडी स्टडीड इन क्लास 10th दैट हाउ और वट इज द सिंपलर फॉर्म ऑफ फैट, वट इज द सिंपलर फॉर्म ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट एंड वट इज द सिंपलर फॉर्म ऑफ प्रोटीन. द सिंपलर फॉर्म ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट इज ग्लूकोज, दिस इज ए मोनोसैकेराइड. द सिंपलर फॉर्म ऑफ प्रोटीन इज अमीनो एसिड, क्लियर. एंड द सिंपलर फॉर्म ऑफ फैट इज फैटी एसिड एंड ग्लिसरॉल. इट मीन्स फैट्स, प्रोटीन एंड कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स डू नॉट गेट डायरेक्टली ऑक्सीडाइज, सो द गेट ऑक्सीडाइज स्टेप बाई स्टेप. वी विल स्टडी दिस थ्रू द फ्लो चार्ट. नाउ लेट्स सी, सपोज दिस इज फैट. सो हाउ द फैट्स गेट ऑक्सीडाइज, मीन्स हाउ दे ब्रेक. फैट गेट कन्वर्टेड इन टू फैटी एसिड एंड ग्लिसरॉल. यू नो दिस इन क्लास 10. Fats get converted into fatty acid and glycerol, which is the simpler form of fat. Again, the fat is turned into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. This is more simpler than glycerol, and the fatty acid is get converted into acetyl-CoA-enzyme. Here you can see fatty acid is oxidized separately and get converted into acetyl-CoA-enzyme. Glycerol is not directly oxidized into acetyl-CoA-enzyme A. It oxidized through two steps. One through glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and second one it get converted into pyruvic acid. Then the pyruvic acid get converted into acetyl-CoA-enzyme A. Same for carbohydrate. Here is the carbohydrate and the simpler form means when carbohydrate breaks, it gives the monosaccharide that is called as glucose. And again the glucose is get oxidized to glucose 6-phosphate and then it is oxidized to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. Again glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate can be reversed. That's why the sign is like this. If we see about proteins, protein get converted into amino acids and amino acids again get oxidized into acetyl-CoA-enzyme. So all these through different steps of oxidation, at last they converted into acetyl-CoA-enzyme. Whether it is fat, carbohydrate or protein, at last they converted into acetyl-CoA-enzyme which enters into the Krebs cycle. And Krebs cycle is involved in aerobic respiration, which is called your tricarboxylic acid cycle or citric acid cycle. And in Krebs cycle, when it enters, then complete oxidation occurs, due to which water and carbon dioxide are released. You know it very clearly that when the complete oxidation of food occurs, then it will give water and carbon dioxide. So we will get water and carbon dioxide when all the substrates means fats, carbohydrates and proteins enter into Krebs cycle, and they are not get directly into Krebs cycle, they all get converted into acetyl-CoA-enzyme A, and acetyl-CoA-enzyme A has an important role in Krebs cycle because the acetyl-CoA-enzyme A which contains 6 carbon, then it get converted into 4 carbon, succinate, then NADH dehydrogenase enzyme, all these enzymatic reactions are occurred. And at last, acetyl-CoA-enzyme A after entering the Krebs cycle releases water and carbon dioxide. So this is how, or this is the reason why respiration is called as amphibolic pathway. Simple, if you write the definition of amphibolic pathway, you can write during respiration, oxygen is used to break the complex substances and oxygen can be used to combine the simple substances. When simple substances combine, they make a complex substance, and when the complex substances break, they make simpler substances. Both the activities, means both anabolic and catabolic activities, takes place during respiration. That's why respiratory pathway can be called as amphibolic pathway. Clear? So now we will study about respiratory quotient, or we can say this as respiratory ratio. What do you mean by respiratory quotient or respiratory ratio? ड्यूरिंग रेस्पिरेशन द अमाउंट ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इवॉल्व एंड द अमाउंट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन कंज्यूम्ड इज कॉल्ड एज इट्स रेस्पिरेटोरी क्वोशेंट. सो हाउ मच अमाउंट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इज कंज्यूम्ड एंड हाउ मच अमाउंट ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इज रिलीज्ड दैट डिपेंड ऑन द टाइप ऑफ सबस्ट्रेट. इट मीन्स वेदर द सबस्ट्रेट इज कार्बोहाइड्रेट प्रोटीन और फैट. फॉर ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ सबस्ट्रेट और फूड मटेरियल द अमाउंट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन मे वैरी. यू नो व्हाई वी टेक नॉर्मली कार्बोहाइड्रेट टाइप ऑफ फूड मैक्सिमम बिकॉज फॉर इट्स ब्रेकडाउन इट नीड्स लेस ऑक्सीजन. बट व्हेन वी टेक फैट एंड प्रोटीन इन लार्ज अमाउंट देन आवर बॉडी रिक्वायर्स लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एंड द एनर्जी रिलीज्ड इज ऑल्सो लेस. दैट्स व्हाई the respiratory quotient can be defined for both carbohydrate, fat and protein. Now let's see. Suppose if we define it in mathematical terms, then respiratory quotient is equal to volume of carbon dioxide evolved upon volume of oxygen consumed. It means हमने respiration के दौरान कितना carbon dioxide निकल रहा है और कितना oxygen consume हो रहा है हम ले रहे हैं उसको बोलेंगे हम respiratory quotient. तो कार्बोहाइड्रेट का ऑक्सीडेशन कैसे होता है और कार्बोहाइड्रेट का ब्रेकडाउन कैसे होता है और जब इसका ब्रेकडाउन होता है तो हमें कितना एनर्जी मिलता है. As you know that respiration, whether it takes place in the presence of oxygen or absence of oxygen, always it gives energy. So suppose this is glucose C6H12O6. This is glucose. And glucose is get oxidized when 6 molecules of oxygen is available. It means for breakdown of 1 molecule of glucose, 6 molecules of oxygen is required. And when 6 molecules of oxygen is added to glucose, then it gives 6CO2 plus 6H2O plus energy. You know it from class 10. But how we will find out the respiratory quotient? So here RQ. RQ is equal to volume of carbon dioxide evolved. So you can see how much amount of carbon dioxide is evolved? 6. So we can write 6CO2 upon oxygen is used, means consumed is 6. That's why 6O2. So 6 upon 6. It means 1. So here the energy we get or the respiratory quotient will be 1. 1 for carbohydrate. And remember students, this may come in your NEET exams and can ask what is the respiratory quotient of carbohydrate. Then you can write 6CO2 means 6 molecules of carbon dioxide is released when 6 molecules of oxygen is consumed. So 6 upon 6 is equal to 1. So the respiratory quotient is here 1. If we see fat, here I want to tell you another thing. Pure protein and pure fat can't be oxidized directly. Pure protein and pure fat can't be oxidized directly or it can't be used as substrate. It means they are used as substrate but in their simpler form. So here for fat we take tripalmitin. Remember tripalmitin is the substrate. And its formula is 2 whole into C51H98O6. Tripalmitin, the formula of tripalmitin is 2 whole into C51H98O6 plus 145 oxygen. It means for one molecule of, for the breakdown of one molecule of tripalmitin, it needs 145 oxygen. But here you can see one molecule of glucose needs 6 molecules of oxygen. But here one molecule of fat, we can say this fat needs 145 oxygen. So when it get oxidized in 145 oxygen, then we get 102 CO2 plus 98 H2O plus energy. As you know that during respiration energy is evolved, so here energy is also evolved, here energy evolved. So now let's see how many carbon dioxide released एंड हाउ मेनी ऑक्सीजन आर कंज्यूम. सो आर क्यू रेस्पिरेटोरी क्वेश्चन इज इक्वल टू 102 CO2 अपॉन में 145 O2 एंड इट गिव्स 0.7. इट मीन्स द ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ फैट रिलीजेस ओनली 0.7. इट मीन्स इट इज लेस देन कार्बोहाइड्रेट. इन कार्बोहाइड्रेट ऑक्सीजन यूज इज लेस बट हियर इन फैट ऑक्सीजन यूज इज मोर बट द अमाउंट ऑफ क्वेश्चेंट रेस्पिरेटोरी क्वेश्चेंट इज ओनली 0.7. सो नाउ यू कैन एस्टिमेट व्हाई वी टेक ए लिटिल अमाउंट ऑफ फैट बिकॉज फैट नीड्स मोर ऑक्सीजन एंड गिव्स लेस रेस्पिरेटोरी क्वेश्चेंट. नेक्स्ट वन इज योर प्रोटीन. द रेस्पिरेटोरी क्वेश्चेंट ऑफ प्रोटीन इज 0.9 एंड दिस इज द वर्क फॉर यू. यू कैन फाइंड आउट द फॉर्मूला ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ प्रोटीन. यू कैन टेक एनी एग्जाम्पल एंड यू सी दैट द रेस्पिरेटोरी क्वेश्चेंट विल बी 0.9. सो रेस्पिरेटोरी क्वेश्चेंट ऑफ प्रोटीन इज 0.9. रेस्पिरेटोरी क्वेश्चेंट ऑफ फैट इज 0.7 एंड द रेस्पिरेटोरी क्वेश्चेंट ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट इज 1.0. सो दिस इज द रेस्पिरेटोरी क्वेश्चेंट ऑफ डिफरेंट सब्सट्रेट दैट यूज्ड ड्यूरिंग रेस्पिरेशन. सो टुडे वी हैव कंप्लीटेड आवर चैप्टर 14 एंड दिस यूनिट प्लांट फिजियोलॉजी इज कंप्लीटेड. फ्रॉम आवर नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द ह्यूमन फिजियोलॉजी. इन दिस वी विल स्टडी ऑल द दिस इज द बेसिक ऑफ क्लास 10 मीन्स digestive system, respiratory system, circulatory system, all these we will study in the next unit. So from tomorrow we will continue our next unit, that is human physiology. For today this is completion of your chapter respiration in plants.